Hey there, guys. Welcome back to part three of my Let's Play. And yeah, again, sorry about the audio cutting out last time, but, well, just for some ungodly reason, my capture card just seemed to have stopped recording my commentary. Lesson one when trying to do a Let's Play series, if you're playing a game that has multiple save states, as save files, use them. Just in case something like that happens, so yeah, you don't have to go and waste like 30 minutes of your life trying to get all the way back up to where you were. Second, just make sure you check every so often. Third, try and keep the video short so that that way you won't have to, don't have to run the risk of, running into that little error. But yeah, we got the slingshot, we ran to Mona Marshall, and, we got ourselves a helipack upgrade. So let's head back to the planet landfill and see where that little pathway takes us. Yeah, you know what they say. It's like riding a bike. You never forget, you just gotta get back in there and practice. Or if you never heard that expression, here's another one. What do we do when we fall off the horse? We get back on! And thankfully, we actually are gymnasts. Or at least Ratchet is. Or you pass for one with that new swing shot of his. So, yeah. Oh yeah, anybody see Zoolander 2? Yeah, I saw it. And, well, let's just say, at least it's not Blues Brothers 2000. That's honestly the best thing I could say about it. I'm betting I should have gotten to see Deadpool. I mean, well, you know what they say. You mean like I've been doing for the last couple of hours, you stupid, stupid AI? Yes, I know how to do this. Thank you. I'm pretty sure that even little kids who are just playing this for the first time probably figured this out. You are not helping. In fact, you are just making me angry. Please stop doing that. Thank you. Just please stop explaining things. And nearly missed. Yeah, I missed it. Oh! So yeah, just aside from an obstacle course and ooh, something new. I like new things. Whatever this is!
Using the latest in precision laser technology, the Gadgetron Trespasser is guaranteed to work on Gadgetron's line of Invinso lock security doors.
Okay, now who would just leave a hacky device out in the middle of nowhere?
Lasers are mounted on each ring of the Invinso lock. Aim the lasers at the receptors on the outside ring to turn them green. All receptors.
Yeah, in other words, it's your basic hacky minigame. We could get some secret stuff. Woo woo woo. Again, I'm pretty sure that these little help tidbits were necessary when the game first came out. And yeah, I'm just kind of been overreacting to nothing. I mean, if you can even call it overreacting. Well, yeah, whatever. Ooh, what's all this here? Oh, wait, links to nothing, okay. That was close. Anything over... Yeah, aside from a straight bolt or two, nothing. Anything? Oh, okay. So yeah, pretty uneventful, but hey, got myself a necessary gadget, so hey, better than nothing. And yeah, finally figured out how to just speed this thing along. Alright. Confront the robot lieutenant. And away we go. Meanwhile, aboard Executive Chairman Drek's flagship.
Yes, quite lovely. That should just about do it. Commander, we are finished with this world. Commence towing our planet to its next destination. Lieutenant!
Yes, sir.
You have fulfilled your tree quota. Barely.
We are ready to return to base.
Not so fast, Lieutenant. Just because we don't need any more trees doesn't mean they should have them. Destroy everything.
Okay, now there's just being a jerk. Yeah, there's being a villain and there's just being a jerk. Planet Eudora. Yep, there's trees. Lots and lots of cheese. Ooh, what's in here? Nothing. Explore the mills. I go where I please. First things first, we got that hacking tool, so let's use it. Yeah. Easy squeezy. You just gotta love the music here. Now we're in for a whimsical romp in the woods. After a whole bunch of alien loggers just basically ripped chunks of the planet out and... Yeah, a question. If Drek is going around ripping off parts of planets, how are they still in orbit? I mean, we see their planet's cores exposed. How are these planets not collapsed or exploded by now? Because reasons, that's why. I'm glad I figured out that little mystery of the universe. There we go. Yeah, slight little elevation change. Yeah, you really gotta time this thing. Otherwise, one false move, and you're down the pit, and... that means extra minutes on the video, which is pretty much bad for all of us. Okay. Spider-Man! Okay, this one's actually a little bit tricky. Yeah. Never mind. Oh, well, you know, there's tons of fun. That was easy.
Oh! Yeesh.
You sure showed him.
I suppose I did.
Mm-hmm.
Is your current occupation leaving a rotten taste in your mouth?
Mm-hmm.
Then you need to know about BTS, Blog Tactical Research Station. Hi, I'm Supreme Executive Chairman Drek. We here at BTS are seeking motivated individuals to fill positions in these exciting careers. Grind boot tester.
Aye!
Assembly technician. Mutant animal husbandry. Robot repair man. Suck cannon test dummy.
Ooh, and new toys!
Assistant. So call BTS. Build our weapons while you build your future.
I'm calling BTS today.
Thanks, corporate sock puppet.
Did you see all the cool gadgets they're making? Let's go get some.
No, we must continue our search for Captain Quark.
You're absolutely right.
Mm-hmm. I am.
Sure, we need to find Quark. Although when we find him, wouldn't it be nice to be able to tell him where Chairman Drek is?
I suppose.
Well, we go to the space station and talk to the scientists. They work for Drek, so they're bound to know where he is.
I am unsure about your logic.
Ah, you think too much. Come on.
You're being too logical!
For the Blog Tactical Station. Although... yeah, again, I probably would have just gone with another method of convincing Clank. Just say, well, look... if we are going to confront, Drek in the first place, we're probably going to need all the gadgets and info and weapons we can get our hands on. So, if and besides, wouldn't it be much better assets to Quark if we were better equipped? So, yeah. But hey, Ratchets works too. And again, it kind of helps that at this point, Clank's kind of a gullible mook. Let's see what we got here.
I got some great bargains for you.
Ooh. Yeah.
Next time, my friend. Next time. Oh, look at that, a whole bunch of little robots. And now they're all charred scrap. More fire! More fire! Anything over here? And to quote Ted Turner, or at least some iteration of him, protect the environment, or I'll fucking kill you, Captain Planet. You gotta love Robot Chicken. Ooh, skill point, cool. A vehicle bombarder. Oh, even better, I got myself a trophy. Okay, I'm playing through the HD collection cold, and I had absolutely no idea I could get a trophy for that. Although some point of contention against it, they don't go and show what the skill points are until you've most likely beaten the game. Thanks a lot there, Insomniac. Well, I'll admit it does encourage you to go and play through it a second time just so you can go and get all the achievements. Although, yeah, you can pretty much go back and unlock all the skill points you want, and once you go and beat Drek, which I'm probably not going to subject you all to, as well, hey, the internet exists, so. And besides, there's more than a good chance that you guys have already beaten this game before. Okay. Stuff going on here, but okay, how is it that the main objective in this level is much shorter than the side objective? Although technically there aren't really like any true side objectives. See, even the most professional players can get themselves a boo-boo every once in a while. None to be ashamed of. Oh, I'll get back to you in just a second. Boxes, boxes, boxes everywhere. Well, hey, at least they have currency in them, otherwise they'd just be completely useless. Hey, don't you talk about my boxes. I like boxes. You know, that line makes so little sense out of context. Sometimes this is better to go up close and personal, you know what I mean? Hold on a second here. Oh, no! Crap baskets! Oh, well. Oh, wait. Nothing to see here, just a little homicidal furball going around smacking up my colleagues. Yeah, well, back to chopping wood. Well, if anything, that wasn't exactly a major league setback or anything like that. I'm just kind of wondering how the mechanics of these weapons actually works if you were trying to make them in real life. Like, are the bombs like energy constructs or something? Or is there actually like some sort of pocket dimension thing that's storing all the bombs inside of it and just, and they could just be let out whenever you call on them? Such deep and wondrous questions that permeate the mind of your board gamer. The average board gamer. Such thoughts were truly never meant to be seen beyond only a distinct group. A distinct group referred to as bored, pretentious idiots. Yeah, that about sums that up. But yeah, and the flamethrower and the blaster make sense, but the bomb glove? Not that I really care, mind you, it's just... Oh, let's see what's open around here, huh? Oh, you... Yep, nothing here but dead men. That's just what I figured. There we go, just making myself a little comfortable. Pulled my back while I was working yesterday. Yeah, I was just moving the display and, well, long story short, well, my back had been bad for a couple of weeks. I was working like a longer shifts than usual. And, well, you know, like, when you don't take care of yourself properly, this sort of stuff tends to happen. So, a lesson to be learned here, kids. If it starts aching, better start complaining before it really starts aching. Just take better care of yourself. Don't do drugs. Ooh, hello, someone big. Big and just made out of tinfoil. That's pretty much my thought. Wait, Glove of Doom, when did I get that? I didn't get that. It's just like, does the game just like, no, I'm going to get it, and then just, oh, you know what, we're not even going to bother. You already got, fill up the rest of your weapons. It's already been displayed into the game's current, into the game store, so, yeah, just might as well be prepared. Well, yeah, that's the kind of consideration I appreciate. Yeah, you saw that robot, right? He was just waving his hand like, come at me, bro. Yep. I came, I brought it, and you sucked. But then again, I can back up a lot when you have a lot of ridiculous guns with, when you have a crap ton of ridiculous guns. Just... Ratchet's got such a long, weird, and diverse arsenal. I'm surprised that the NRA hasn't made him their unofficial, hasn't made them his official mascot. Yeah, Ratchet, defending your rights to bear as many ridiculous arms as possible. America! Yeah, I'm just running around the forest. The NRA. You can sure as hell carry any flamethrower you want, because this here's America! And why can't I get myself a flamethrower? I survived Nam! I'm sure as hell entitled to get myself a flamethrower! And what the fuck does anything have to do with Vietnam? What the fuck are you talking about? I should probably just stop using the flamethrower because I might be sending the wrong message. Is that what I think it is? Is that a new weapon for me to play with? And I'm saved! Yes.
Sweet!
Gadgetron's suck cannon can vacuum up multiple enemies.
Huh. The suck cannon, huh? Very sucky. Oh, come on! It certainly does suck! Yeah, no, this is actually one of the better weapons. You could, you know what? Why tell you when I can show you? Yeah, it just allows you to suck up smaller enemies like it was Moroku's wind tunnel and then blammo! And that was a complete failure.
Now,
the glove of doom.
I got some great bargains for you today.
Let's see. Launch a horde of exploding buddies to chase down your foes. You know what? I just might need the ammo.
Fuzzball.
Never mind. Like I said, it's out in the field, and if I really need to conserve energy, I'll just go and use the suck can for a little while. Yep, all good here. So yeah, just to, again, make sure that we're not stuck, just to make sure that the audio doesn't cut out again, I think this is where we'll cut it for today. Next time, Blarg Station and Nebula G34. So, until next time, this is David Lab. I'm telling you to stay classy, San Diego.